we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section analysis, and the problem is on the convergence of a given sequence. This question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is, let Xn be a sequence of positive real numbers. Which of the following statements are true? Options. Option 1, if the two subsequences x2n, that is the subsequence with even indexed terms, and x2n plus 1, that is subsequence with odd indexed terms, converge, then the sequence xn converges. If the sequence minus 1 to the power of n into xn converges, then the sequence xn converges. Option 3, if limit n tends to infinity xn plus 1 by xn exists, then the sequence xn to the power of 1 by n is bounded. Option 4, if the sequence xn is unbounded, then every subsequence is unbounded. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We are given the sequence xn of the positive terms. Let's consider the statement given in option 1. If the two subsequences x2n and x2n plus 1 converge, then the given sequence xn converges. And this is not true. To say so, we consider the sequence xn where xn is equal to 1 if n is odd, xn is equal to 2 if n is even. Now, the subsequence x2n plus 1, that is the odd indexed terms, is 1, 1, 1, etc., a constant sequence, and it converges to 1. The subsequence x2n, the even indexed terms, is 2, 2, 2, etc., again a constant sequence, converges to 2. Assume that the sequence, the given sequence xn, is convergent and converges to L, say. Then it is known that every subsequence of a convergent sequence also converges and converges to L. So since the subsequence x2n and x2n plus 1 are converging to two different limits, the sequence xn is not convergent. Therefore, the option 1 is not true. Let's go to the next option. That is, the statement given in option 2 is, if minus 1 to the power of n xn converges, then the sequence xn also converges. And we have the following well-known result. If xn is a sequence of positive real numbers such that the sequence minus 1 to the power of n xn converges to L, then L is equal to 0. Therefore, in the light of this result, the option 2 is true. I will now show you the proof of this result. Proof of the result. We have the sequence xn of positive real numbers and minus 1 to the power of n xn, the sequence converges to L. Then every subsequence of xn converges and converges to L. Therefore, the subsequence with even index terms, that is minus 1 to the power of 2n x2n, and that will be the subsequence x2n, and the odd index terms subsequence minus 1 to the power of 2n plus 1 x2n plus 1, and that will be the subsequence minus x2n plus 1 of the sequence minus 1 to the power of n xn converges to L. Now, L greater than or equal to 0. Why? Because x2n is greater than 0 for all n belongs to n. On the other hand, L less than or equal to 0. Why? Because minus x2n plus 1 is less than 0 for all n greater n belongs to n. Thus, the L is both greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 0. This is only possible when L is equal to 0. That is, the given sequence minus 1 to the power of n xn converges to 0. So, that is the result. If the sequence xn of positive real numbers such that minus 1 to the power of n xn converges to L, then L must be equal to 0. Hence the result. Now let's move to the statement given in option 3. If limit n tends to infinity xn plus 1 by xn exists, then the sequence xn to the power of 1 by n is bounded. Recall the Cauchy's second theorem on limits. It says, let xn be a sequence of positive real numbers, and if limit n tends to infinity xn plus 1 by xn is equal to L, then the sequence xn to the power of 1 by n is convergent and converges to L. Now, the sequence xn to the power of 1 by n is bounded. Why? Because it is convergent and converges to L. And we know every convergent sequence is bounded. Therefore, xn to the power of 1 by n being convergent, it is also bounded. So, therefore, the option 3 is true. Now, let's move to the last option, that is option 4. If the sequence xn is unbounded, then every subsequence is unbounded. And this is not true. To say so, we will give a counter example. Consider the sequence xn where xn is equal to 1 if n is odd and xn is equal to n by 2 if n is even. Then the sequence will be 1, 1, 1, 1, and so on and so forth. So, this sequence is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, etc., etc. And clearly, this sequence xn is unbounded because it is going on increasing, at least the even terms are increasing. And it has a subsequence x2n plus 1 with odd index terms, that is 1, 1, 1, which is bounded. So, this is here is an example which is an unbounded sequence where one of its subsequence is bounded. So, the statement that every subsequence is unbounded is not true. So, therefore, the option 4 is not true. So, our final answer is the options 2 and 3 are true. That is the discussion of the solution of the problem that is appearing in National Eligibility Test on the sequences. and their convergence. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems from the section sequences and the convergences. I wish you all the best. Thank you.